Hi, this is Sherry Bratz from Hillview, Kentucky. I want to give you a little bit of an idea of what my day is like and what my life is like, with people attacking my brain, trying to keep me a slave, and destroying my health every day through torture, saying they're feeding some kind of demon. Today I get up 8:30, get my dog, we go walking for an hour, and I go back to sites I went to yesterday to do some more pictures. After I walked with her for an hour and I took pictures beforehand for like, I left at 8:30, took pictures for half hour, then I walked for an hour, and I just went to Chili's for lunch. They're having a 3 for $10 special, so I had enchiladas and guacamole and a beverage, and then I felt myself getting really dizzy, and I looked over and there was this guy. He looked kind of like a scientist. And I knew he had to have one of those controls that they mark you with when you go out in public and attack your brain when you go out in public to keep your brain weak so it stays in this matrix or whatever. I got really tired, really dizzy. I couldn't hardly stay awake on the way home. I ran over my dad's garbage can, picked it up, turned around, backed up to it again. That's what these mind weapons do. They're totally turning me into a zombie. They want to kill me now. They're drawing all these pictures of me because I pray. For all these years, they kept me a tortured, whittling away at my mind, sending me perverse things, evil things, following me in cars, even through the desert from Las Vegas, California, because they wanted material off my laptops, breaking into my hotel rooms to steal my computers, breaking into my homes. Now they just want to just draw pictures of me and devour me. They said some vampire was to eat me because I break out because I pray. But for all these years, their intention is for you not to pray. They wanted me to feel like my brain was being so taken over by something that they were making me dumber all the time. They wanted it to have control. They say a transformation is taking place. I didn't believe them. But when you look at pictures of me, I mean, some people say the pictures are blurred. My eyes look bigger, like the demon eyes you see a lot of people get. And they say there's an alien in me. But at night, they invade my dreams. But the torture is real. They've destroyed my spine. They're blinding me. They're destroying my internal organs. When you see these people, supposedly this cult, eating people and doing all this ritualistic stuff, it's real. But the problem is they're not just limiting it to their cult. They're wanting to do this to the world now. And I'm one of these people that have been one of their slow kill victims. I have got hard drive evidence that this started, I think the year 1997. I can't be for sure about the year, but I know the year I got an invitation to go to a conference with a deer stamp. And this person was talking to me online, pretending to be a horror writer and sending me secret admirer messages with this phantom figure wearing a trench coat. And then this horror writer turns out and does a new book with a trench coat. I started kind of smelling a rat, but I wanted to break free. I just wanted to write. I just wanted a mentor. What person would pay thousands of dollars to go to all these conferences if they didn't want to be published or they didn't want to polish their talent? I did. It's getting me murdered. Because when I got wise and I found out what people were doing, and some of these people were part of a cult, well, one of them happened to be gay. So I got these armies after me now saying, because you won't willingly let us steal your work after they stole it for 4 or 5 years without my awareness, we're just going to kill you and make you a victim. Because other people, they said, either turned up dead or didn't talk. And then they had all these strangers call me from around the world threatening to murder me and everything. And my stuff started appearing in films by Illuminati type group, in top films. And everything I wrote is pretty much either gone to the theater or it's gone to DVD. It's been that way for years, but they keep me in the shadows. They beat me down because I'm a woman. They never give me credit. And they tell me they're going to kill me in some ritual eventually. They said they want this horror writer to make me his seventh victim. And they want to rip my heart out. These people are not just fair. They hate women. They are bloodsuckers. They are into Satanism. They destroy people. They cut them up. They show me women they've raped and stuck terrible things inside that they keep prisoner somewhere in some sort of home or prison where they just rape them and drug them and have them pose. They send that stuff. They send me pictures of cut up people. They threaten to do horrible things because I got wise. They're into porn, trafficking people, everything. This is the group that took an interest in me. And now they're sending me these clowns they call the killer clowns. And they're sending me deer antlers and telling me I am their stalked prey. And they're just mutilating my body every day with these weapons. They try to do it where you don't even know because it's untraceable weapons. But the thing they're trying to invade my mind with is connected to some kind of mega computer. And you can see old videos on the internet that were done in Maryland through Persinger, P-E-R-S-I-N-G-E-R, and other scientists where years ago they were studying how the piggyback in things to totally control the mind. And they found those weapons in my home. Two different detectives brought equipment that was over $100,000. One was from California, one was from New York. They did a home sweep. They said there were radio waves here that went out of state that shouldn't be here, that didn't go to radio stations. One guy traced them to two different train stations, one in Florida and one in Kansas. The other guys couldn't trace them, but he said they shouldn't be here and they were strong radio waves. By the time they found cutouts on my land, they thought were done skillfully done by military people. And they said people were coming on my property watching me at night we had no awareness of. And my strange stepson, who had never been to our home once, asked to visit for the first time in 12 years. And his sister asked to visit at the same time, which is very strange. And she'd never been to our home, and we've been here 10 years. So it was very strange, and they're all affiliated with military. But I don't know who was doing the cutouts on our property, but there's pictures. And they said this is way high up. So not only am I some kind of government experiment, now they're telling me I'm some kind of sacrifice, all because I have a talent. And they're trying to infiltrate me. And they say, if I will not let this happen, they're just gonna kill me. And not only they said, well, if I won't let them infiltrate me, then they wanna impregnate me and try to make me have, they said, a demon baby. And I'm like, this is like something out of Rosemary's Baby. They think if they cannot totally destroy my soul, then they just wanna infest me with something. And then later they said, if they kill it, it will break my heart so bad it will damn my soul if they kill it. They said there's nothing worse than having a baby than going through all that labor and have it be a sacrifice. They tell me this stuff. They also tell me this movie name called Mother was done off of their intentions for me. But they try to make me a part of every creation. Not only do they steal my stuff, they try to terrorize me and torture me in ways to get me to react, they say, to have convincing story material. Then they put the stuff in movies and they get me, they said, flipped out to where I'm just terrified, but they want me to interact with them online for dialogue. And they said they put it in the movies. And it's like stealing my soul, they think. Like recording my voice and playing it back to me and when I'm terrorized or terrified, making me cry and play it back to me, putting hidden cameras in my home when they said I was so moral before, then telling me they put them everywhere, nude pictures, Asian sites all over the place. It's all degrading, it's all evil, and I really don't have any outlet.